Welcome to the theater, your theater, one that represents many things to many people. Your theater is show business. The brilliance is a marketplace, displaying wares of the world for your inspection. Your theater is a style center. It is a travel agency. It is a sports arena. It is a concert hall. Whatever your tastes, your theater is a box seat on life. Your theater is more. It is a member of your community. Whatever concerns you, concerns it. It is a business, a local hometown business that depends on local hometown people for its management and operation. This means work and payrolls, employment and income for citizens of this community. Being a business, your theater is a customer of your bank. It patronizes your local newspapers. It stimulates business with local merchants. It buys from your utilities companies, mechanics, printers, carpenters, from suppliers of every sort and description. Your theater then means profit and revenue for the community. At the hub of all this activity is the exhibitor, the manager of your theater. His is a life of public welfare and private enterprise. As an administrator, he operates your theater cleanly, safely, and courteously. He trains his staff well for your pleasure. He provides you with clear projection and good sound. He gives you comfortable seats and a warm, pleasant environment for your enjoyment of pictures. As a public servant, your exhibitor is active in civic affairs, cooperating fully in the social betterment of the community. He serves in business, religious, and professional organizations, and in so doing makes his theater your theater, a focal point in community life. As an impresario, your exhibitor conducts a continuous poll of what you like and do not like. For motion pictures are a sounding board of your likes and dislikes. When you like them, you show it. You show it in your reactions, in your conversations, and in your return to this theater. And you show it in box office receipts, your theater's gauge of success in pleasing you. You show your dislike, too. When a picture does not please you, both you and the exhibitor know it. So he does everything possible to give you what you want. And what a problem this can be. For example, this woman wants more musical shows. These boys want more westerns. These girls, more love stories. This man, more adventure. Others want more travel, comedy, mystery, romance, thrillers, more everything. Your exhibitor then has the difficult assignment of selecting a varied fare for your enjoyment day in and day out. He works continually to maintain a theatrical tradition, which has made the motion picture theater so much an ingrained part of our social life that difficult to imagine what it would be like without it. Suppose for a moment that the lights of this theater of ours went dark. What then? What would serve instead? Stage shows? Of course. If, that is, such shows were nearby, and if we all could afford them as easily as we can movies. The greatest entertainment value per dollar in the world. Music? Naturally. If, again, music were available and at modest motion picture prices. Drama? Yes, but not drama just down the street from us. Not new plays every few days. There would not be anything important that many schools supplement textbooks and schoolrooms with recommended attendance at showings of various pictures. Your theater, then, is an American institution. So come in and welcome. Welcome from friends, from fellow citizens, from the world's storehouse of talent, poured into the mold of your particular pleasure. Welcome from the theater, your theater, to you.